Yeah, finished in 12. Welcome to Know the APEC, Yes to Global Worker Solidarity. My name is Bob Price. I'm going to be the chair. I'm the chair of the event tonight, and I'm a member of the Freedom Socialist Party. And welcome everyone. The Freedom Socialist Party is a socialist feminist group that was started in 1966 as the first explicitly socialist feminist party. We fight for a socialist society that will provide justice for all oppressed people, women, queer folks, people of color, and we recognize the revolutionary leadership potential of the most marginalized. We believe the most oppressed people are essential to lead the movements that will build to overthrow profit system, in particular, Black folks in the US because of their historic role in leading social justice struggles in this country throughout history. So for us, it's a key part of building for a better world is to study history, to talk about current situations that are going on, and to get involved. And that's what this event tonight is all about, for getting everyone familiar with what this free trade agreement and free trade grouping called APEC is. Asian Pacific Economic Cooperation. And Christina is going to give a presentation, of course, that will say so much more about that. I'm going to call on Sarah because she's going to make an announcement about our raffle prize tonight. So, Sarah, and we'll move the microphone a little bit. So, it's probably good right there.
Can everyone hear me? Yes. Cool. Okay, great. So tonight we are raffling off Globalize This. So this awesome book is an anthology. It's got work by a lot of different authors from different political groups about what happened in Seattle in 1999. There was the Battle of Seattle. I think it was like 700 people were arrested. Tear gas, it was this whole thing. And so this book was published prior to that in you know, prior to those protests. And it talked about like all about how free trade was really bad for the people's worlds back then, about 23 years ago. And so this kind of helped provide context about these global free trade deals that happen. And you know, they're basically all for the billionaires and not for the working class. And this helps provide a kind of a good backing about some of the same things that we're going to be seeing at this APEC conference. You can get raffle tickets for $1 each, or sorry, the camera's in reverse, it's kind of hard. You can get raffle tickets for $1 each or three for $2.50. If you would like to get a raffle ticket to have a chance to win Globalize This, then please put that in the Zoom chat and let us know, and I will write some raffle tickets.
All right, thank you, Sarah. All right, and then we have a literature announcement that I'm just going to go ahead and make. In line with tonight's topic, I have a few books to bring to your attention and also our newspaper, The Freedom Socialist. One is this book called One Hemisphere Indivisible, Permanent Revolution and Neoliberalism in the Americas. So again, you're going to hear about free trade agreements tonight in the Asia-Pacific region. But this book, which our party published many years ago, actually in 2006, talks about what free trade did to countries throughout Latin America. So it was one of our convention political resolutions, but it really gives a very good overview of what neoliberalism has done and how it destroyed so many people's livelihoods and caused the migration crisis that we're seeing to this day. So that goes for $8. So if anyone's interested in that, I encourage you to get it. Nancy has posted in the chat the information on ordering these books from Red Letter Press, if they're of interest to people out there in Zoom land. And then the next piece, or the next thing I'll focus on is eco-socialism, the solution for survival of planet Earth. It's again a book that put, it's a pamphlet the FSP has put out that talks about the need to get rid of the capitalist system and the profit system if we want to have a sustainable earth, and if we actually want to save the earth, because capitalism, as we can see, is just destroying it completely. So that's for $5.50. Again, you can order from Red Letter Press through the link, or if you're in the room, we have copies here. So encourage people to check that out. And then one book, not a book that we haven't published ourselves, but that is from our bookshelves, is called Evil Paradises, Dream Worlds of Neoliberalism. And what this talks about is how cities, urban centers are being built where the very rich have all these towers with all these luxuries. And then you see a ring around those of poverty. And we're even seeing that in San Francisco right now. Here we are in the Tenderloin, where the most impoverished people are living out on the streets. And just a few blocks away are some of the most wealthy residents in their apartments. So we're seeing it here, but this talks about it in a global sense. And that goes for $15 is our special price. It's not the publisher price. So if that interests you, let us know in the chat or anyone in the room here if you're interested, $15 for this book. And then finally, I wanted to highlight the Freedom Socialist, our socialist feminist press. It's actually, its lead article talks about global warming. As you can see, the thing says hot there. Brutal heat calls for a systemic change. And it comes out six times a year, a dollar an issue. And what we're doing now, though, and what I would encourage everyone who's hearing me, if you haven't already, is to subscribe, because we're in the midst of a subscription drive and we've lowered the price by half. And so this is a subscription form, but people online can go to the link in the, again, in the chat that Nancy put up with the other book information, and subscribe online at the very low price of $5 a year. So we really appreciate getting folks signed up to be subscribers. It assures that the Freedom Socialist has some money it can count on in a general sense and keep publishing for a few more years, because it's difficult and expensive to keep an independent paper like ours going. But we appreciate all your help, those of you who are subscribers and readers. So thanks very much. Those are the lit announcements. All right, so at this point, we're ready to actually start our program. And Christina Lee, our comrade, is going to be the presenter. And she's presenting from a set of slides that were mostly prepared or inspired by those from the coalition, the NOTA APEC coalition, with our own annotations and our own information added. So so this will be a slide presentation that you'll be seeing shared to your screens at home in a moment when we get started. And in the room here, I will put up the presentation so it's really big on the screen so everyone can read the slides and see the graphics as we go along. Christina Lee is a member of the Freedom Socialist Party and the Comrades of Color Caucus, which is a subgrouping within both the Freedom Socialist Party and Radical Women, a group that spans those two groups that share a common purpose and program. And she's a member of the SEIU 10 to 1, that's Service Employees International Union 10 to 1, the local that represents city workers here in San Francisco, which is what she is. So Christina, we're gonna go to you and get the presentation started.
All right. Thank you very much, Bob. All right. So let me just move some of the Zoom stuff out of the way. All right. So APEC, or the Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation, is an intergovernmental forum to promote free trade in the Asia Pacific region. It started in 1989 as a means for the economic leaders of the Asia Pacific region to begin working more closely together in response to the establishment of similar trade blocs around the world. As APEC sees it, their mission is to facilitate regional economic growth through free trade, investment liberalization, business facilitation, and economic and technical cooperations to realize a free trade region in the Asian Pacific. APEC says that they are the premier platform for the United States to advance economic policies in the Asia-Pacific region to promote free, fair, and open trade. But when they say free trade, they mean increasing capitalist abilities to exploit workers and benefit corporate interests. They mean increasing U.S. hegemony in the Asia-Pacific region, building upon centuries of American military and economic exploitation of Asian Pacific countries for capitalist benefit. There are 21 countries that participate in APEC as so-called member economies. As APEC says, they are championing free and open trade and investment, promoting and accelerating regional economic integration, encouraging economic and technical cooperation, enhancing human security, and facilitating a favorable and sustainable business environment. What this means to the working class is APEC is a group of capitalist leaders meeting regularly in order to plot how they can enrich themselves as the ruling political and economic classes of their various nations, and to make sure that multinational corporations have free rein without any impediments. So San Francisco gets to be the host city for the 2023 APEC Economic Leaders Week. The AELW will include government officials and corporate leaders making plans with no significant input from unions and workers. And so this is why we need to oppose APEC and fight against spending San Francisco taxpayer money on it. Their 2023 priorities range from addressing supply chain shocks, struggling health systems, food insecurity, and climate change, all of which they as capitalists have caused and continue to perpetuate. They are the problem, not the solution. APEC member countries control 75% of the global mining trade and investment in the region. They make up 60% of global demand for energy, and they control 55% of global energy production. APEC is also the destination for more than 60% of U.S. goods exports, and includes seven of the top 10 overall trading partners for the U.S. And U.S. multinational corporations are very determined to maintain economic control over the industries and countries within the grouping, while using their influence to leverage their positions against economic rivals. So APEC is a proponent of neoliberalism. Neoliberalism is the ideology and methods under which global capitalism has operated during the last 40 years. It is a framework predicated on the notion that free market capitalism is the best method to establish prosperity and freedom for all. In practice, neoliberalism has pumped capital into emerging markets, leaving them at the mercy of banks and speculators, and in the Pacific region, often putting them into an alliance with the United States against China. It is a means to coerce poorer countries to open their markets to foreign products and investments for the benefit of investor nations. So, what do APEC schemes mean for the working class in their member countries? It means that jobs disappear when they become less profitable for big business. It means that prices for food, gas, clothing, medicine, and rent skyrocket. Workers lose access to or go into debt for essential goods like healthcare, education, and housing. Indigenous people's rights and land continue to be stolen and plundered, Well, the planet is poisoned, and the working class loses their political voice. This is why the global working class must unite to defend ourselves against the capitalists. When capitalist economic frameworks are able to run rampant, corporations become richer than entire countries. Corporations are able to essentially own and control countries through foreign direct investment and financial control boards. Capitalist states intervene economically and militarily on corporations' behalf and are able to control foreign governments and destroy indigenous social systems. These are all manifestations of imperialism. Capitalists divide the resources and profits of the world amongst themselves and force the global working class to fight for the crumbs. Last May, the United States launched the Indo-Pacific Economic Framework for Prosperity, or IPEF, with Australia, Brunei, Fiji, India, Indonesia, Japan, the Republic of Korea, Malaysia, New Zealand, the Philippines, Singapore, Thailand, and Vietnam. The 14 IPEF partners represent 40% of global GDP and 28% of the global goods and services trade. So this graph shows the percentage of global gross domestic product accounted for by countries in different free trade agreements. Not only do the two proposed free trade zones in the Asia-Pacific region represent more than double the economic clout seen in NAFTA, the agreement made amongst the United States, Mexico, and Canada in the 90s, but they also represent regional economic rivalries with RCEP, the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership led by China, and IPEF led by the United States. IPEF is part of the United States' Pivot to Asia military and economic strategy. Its goal is to contain China and advance U.S. economic interests supported by militarization of allies in the region, so Japan, South Korea, and the Philippines, setting up new military agreements with Australia, and increasing foreign military bases in the Asian Pacific. The United States is trying to convince the working class and leaders of less developed countries that IPEF represents a kinder, gentler form of free trade. IPEF is really just a rebranding of the exact same framework capitalists have long used to oppress and control other nations. It's hiding that it was crafted and intended to isolate China by surrounding it with American allies and reinforcing trade balances that keep underdeveloped countries in debt and reliant on foreign powers like the U.S., while enriching and keeping the ruling classes of participating countries in power as long as they submit to capitalism.
Can we pause a moment? Because I want to try to get the, I have to switch screens. I see that the caption covers a lot of times the bottoms of the slides. So let me go in and fix that in Zoom before you proceed. Probably it's going to be better there. Oh, it doesn't move. I think maybe everyone can do that on a computer. All right. I thought I could correct that globally, but it looks like on each person's computer, if you're finding your captioning is blocking your ability to read some of the letters, you can drag the caption to the sides, all right, just to let people know. I thought it was an overall thing. So we'll go back to the presentation. Just a moment. That's the problem. Impactful moments. All right. Sorry, we couldn't correct it individually, though. The caption blocks your view. Just move it to the side. So here we go. Resuming. Sorry about that interruption.
All right. Free trade movements hurt the whole working class, but women take the brunt. Capitalists impoverish, pollute, and destroy our communities and safety nets, increasing the burden on women, who in dual roles as workers inside and out of the home, struggle to ensure that families and households are fed, clothed, housed, and healthy. It's very telling that IPEF is promoting their upskilling plans as a means to help women, when their clean economy pillar will affect the most marginalized, Indigenous people and women, as the push for mining lithium, nickel, cobalt, and other materials needed for clean energy increases. It will continue to harm women around the world under the guise of helping them by promoting these upskilling initiatives to train women to work in industries that are reliant upon these extractive industries and build up invasive big tech systems, which can and are being used to privatize public services, enabling governments and countries to discriminate against vulnerable populations and to punish women seeking to exercise their reproductive rights. The No to APEC Coalition has been building a movement highlighting the struggles and resistance of workers, migrants, youth, women, and many others against APEC's corporate agenda. The goals of the No to APEC Coalition are to expose and oppose APEC as a tool to advance imperialist economic and political interests, confront APEC and intensify the struggle against neoliberalism and imperialist plunder, exploitation, and war, confront capitalists and heads of state attending APEC, increase working people's understanding of neoliberalism, its impacts, and current manifestations in local communities in the United States and around the world, particularly against oppressed peoples and nations in the Asian Pacific. And then it project workers, we want to also project workers' calls for sovereignty, pro-people, pro-worker, and pro-environment economy, and mutually beneficial trade relations. So this campaign is built on alliance building, political education, mass propaganda, and actions, leading to a People's Summit and No to APEC action in November in San Francisco. As a socialist feminist revolutionary party, the Freedom Socialist Party sees this coalition as part of the effort to build a multi-issue anti-capitalist movement to replace capitalism with global socialism and to put the working class in charge. Through our participation in this coalition, we will point out that the crucial leadership of those most marginalized by capitalism, women, people of color, LGBTQIA folks, youth, and people with disabilities is needed. The need for an inclusive, multi-issue, multiracial approach. On the necessity of united fronts led and controlled by working people of all who oppose free trade and the policies of neoliberalism. And the importance of opposing anti-Asian racism and scapegoating, while at the same time recognizing and opposing China's imperialism. Join with the Freedom Socialist Party to be part of the Counter Summit on Saturday, November 11th, and protests on Sunday, November 12th, and up through November 18th. Contact us at BayAreaFSP@socialism.com to get involved. And then if you would like more information on the No to APEC Coalition, check out the links that we are putting in the chat.